First of all, it needs to be manufactured at scale, ideally close to where it's being used, depending on the vaccine. It needs to be purchased, so somebody somewhere needs to put the money up to pay for it. And then, of course, it needs to reach people, it needs to be distributed. People need to want to take it, so they need to be informed and convinced that this is the right thing to do, and it's the right thing for them and their families, because ultimately we need a majority of the population to be vaccinated for the vaccine to work. Depending on the type of product, it could be fridge temperature 2 to 8 degrees Celsius, or it could be a normal freezer, or ultra cold chain, so minus 70, minus 80. And so the vaccine basically goes off if it's not kept in these conditions. It's hard to see how it would work in settings where there's no electricity, for instance. And there have been investments in solar paneled fridges, for instance, to get products that are required to be refrigerated to people who need them. Some vaccines are easier to administer by people who are more generally sort of trained, and some vaccines require a lot more sophistication. You might need different levels of skills of healthcare workers to take it out of, for instance, ultra cold refrigeration, perhaps to mix it on the spot, depending on the type of the vaccine.
Say you're in a remote village in the Philippines, it might take 8 hours of travel to get to where you're walking, you're riding a bicycle, you're taking a boat. It's very difficult to get these vaccines to people. Another problem is that if you're living in a poor country, you might be living hand to mouth, right? So if you don't work that day, that might mean your kids don't eat that day. Are you going to be able to travel to a health clinic to get the vaccine? One of the greatest possibilities for people in poor countries to access the vaccine is through the COVAX initiative, which is basically a collaboration of countries that have agreed to help distribute the vaccine. That initiative has promised to provide vaccines for 20% of the global population, aiming to do that by the end of 2021. But even those countries that have joined, some countries in the EU, for instance, and the UK, are buying up some of that supply. But it's still, I think, the best chance of getting a vaccine for many poor countries.
The most optimistic scenarios, you know, we'll be looking at 12 to 18 months, perhaps 2 years, before the whole of the world is vaccinated. But certainly some countries, wealthy countries, will get there first. That's for sure.